Alrighty, welcome back. So Chase, it is Friday and that weather out there is pretty great actually. How long is this going to stick around?
For a couple of days, believe it or not. Now I remember in the summer we had that heat dome push through. It looks like it's about to come back because, you know, El Nino. Then we saw clouds really kind of clear up, and depending on what side of the Concho Valley you were on, you either saw thunderstorms to the north or you just kept seeing a lot of clouds really pushing in from the north. Right now, we're going to continue to see some of those conditions outside, seeing the temperature change over the last 24 hours into those 60s. And that's where we're kind of leveled out for a little while as we continue to see those temperatures already beginning that cool down. Now, as we start to see a lot you can already see some of those severe weather outlooks being issued for northern counties right now. And we're going to continue to see this storm develop as it continues to push really east. In fact, the radar showing you where the highest concentrations of some of these thunderstorms are going to start pushing through, but they're going to be very, very quick because the storm still in those early stages of development. In fact, when we look at the future cast, this is where we could see them push in by about tonight. The bulk of it really kind of making its way out, and again, seeing those wetter conditions now by Saturday morning. That's when we see that cloud cover really make its return with some of that colder air, but we're still going to be holding in those 40s, believe it or not. And then it's going to push out by about Saturday around that lunchtime, similar like today. And then that's it. It's really going to dry up. We're going to watch this storm really push off to the east. Now, it's a pretty big storm, and we're going to continue to watch it really move up towards the northeast, and it's going to start dumping rounds of snow, ice and rain across the entire northeast. While that cloud cover really stays clear, we're under that good influence of high pressure. While we're looking off the west coast, that's going to be the next storm we're making its way in. You can already see it wrapping around this high pressure off to the west coast. In fact, the moisture tracker is showing you how this dry air is really going to take over the central United States. And if we get a good idea of what it looks like, if it does look familiar, that's because that was that heat dome that's going to push back in. El Nino is still here. This trough is going to make its way off to the east as the weekend rolls around, literally looking like a beautiful one in those 60s, but that ridging really just makes its way in. Now you can see how it's made its return. This is it. That's that high pressure we're consistently looking for. And as we continue to watch this low pressure move off to the east, this is where we're going to watch for this high pressure to weaken. This next storm making its way through by about the middle of February. This could be another good cold plunge, but we're keeping our eye on it. So tonight, dropping back down into those 40s. Remember, those clouds could push back in. Could see some light rain make its way through before we watch those Saturday morning clouds push back in that usual AM fog, some light rain shower activity, that PM sun. And then that's it. Things really going to dry up and get beautiful. So please do not waste this weekend. There's a lot going on, and those temperatures are going to be perfect. We're going to be in the 60s with lows in those lower 40s, and that's going to be it. And then by the beginning of next week, we're going to start watching those clouds push back in, but those temperatures still really comfortable in those 60s as that cloud cover increases as we make our way through towards that first week of February. Those lows are still down in those 40s, but believe it or not, touching up into those 50s. Stay tuned with more of the break. You're watching KSN News at 5.